With the news tonight, I'm Royston Drakes. Thanks for joining us. Murder suicide rocked the Williamsburg community, leaving two families in shock. The peace of the normally quiet community of Williamsburg, Quarantine Babies, was disturbed with news of a murder suicide on Sunday. Dead are 40-year-old Injawati Totaram and her reputed husband, Krishna Lachman, 36. They are reported that Lachman took his own life after he stabbed the woman multiple times about her body. Relatives said the two shared a common law relationship for 10 years, and the incident stemmed from the man accusing the woman of having an affair with another man.
He gone, she was crying right on the bench, and I told me that she got dead, so Uncle Jukes is going to kill she. So I said, no, why you go kill you first? You never do you nothing. She crying and tell me, yes, he go kill she. So she had money, and she take the money and give it to me, so I carry. She carry the money to me, tell she no. So keep everything. She take out ship, bangle, and everything. I tell me, carry it for, make it for my son. I'm banned from my son, so she got dead. So I tell him no mercy, so I come back Friday for see you. So Uncle Jukes is never doing nothing, and she was crying, and that is it.
Injawati was reportedly found lying naked and motionless in a pool of blood on the floor in the bedroom with an electric wire tied around her neck. A knife, which appeared to be the murder weapon, was found with blood stains on top of a fridge in the kitchen. A resident of the community, who immediately alerted the police at the Rose Hall Police Station, made the gruesome discovery. Today, family members of the dead woman were struggling to come to terms with her death and were pondering what may have triggered a man to take her life.
But he's a kindly person. We didn't expect him to do that. 10 to 12 years. And all the time, them always have a ups and downs. And she just always go away. And she just come back. When he take a little drink and he's sober, she just come back. But I never heard that he ever say he gonna murder she or he gonna hang himself or whatever.
Totaram was employed with Spreadies as a cleaner, and Lachman was a cane harvester. More news after this break. Stay with us.
Hey, looky there. Let me go to techie boots.
Boots? No, mama. I ain't gonna get lock up teeth in a big stinky 30-second boots. Plus, it gonna be more cheaper online. And don't got my favorite color, pink.
Let me go on.
Online shopping. Cheaper, faster, better. Pass back.
Introducing the two, now available, Softex's Silky Surgeon Pulp, Softex Touch, even baby, manufactured and distributed by Beep, Eccles Industrial Site, 2 Softex Toilet Tissue, super durable, guaranteed.
I want to buy a blue chair for my mom because she likes it. I'm going to get my daddy a big barbecue grill so he can cook some beef and chicken. A fridge for mom and a TV for dad. Santa, can you please spell my name correctly?
Sunday, December 10th, all roads lead to 63 Beach on the Quarantine for a main event. Extra beer and extra energy drinks, car and bike show, and Mr. High DJ competition. An action-packed day on the beach where the cars and bikes fight for supremacy. And the DJs from Thunderbolt, Team Mega High, Black Master, Fire International, DJ Tunde, High Range, Showtime Sound, Street Sense, Team After Dark, Selector Elephant, and DJ Rangan will fight to see who will be Mr. High. And when it comes to juggling, DJ Magnum, Golly Ress and Diamond, 7-1 Sound, DJ Bajan, Selector Andre and Damon, David High and DJ Fresh will be on duty as Murphy Invasion One Man Band and Stitchy Vibes Machine, the Rokotux Boss, Face Off. There's also going to be a fun day for the entire family. The extra beer and extra energy drink, Karen Bike Show, and Mr. High DJ Competition, Sunday 10th December on 63B. All courtesy GTT, Homeline Furnishing, and Extra Beer, the perfect beer.
Welcome back. A bartender was found dead in a canal near a cemetery.
23-year-old Mercer Fraser of Lot 24 Public Road, No. 4 Village West Coast, Barbies, met a dreadful death early this morning. Fraser's body was fished out of a trench along a cemetery. Her face was covered in mud, and she was naked from the waist down. Burbage Divisional Command Assistant Commissioner Lyndon Alves disclosed to this publication that investigators are treating the incident as a homicide because multiple stab wounds were found on the body when it was taken out of the waterway. The part-time bartender was last seen by her cousin at home where she lived at Number 4 Village at approximately 1:45 hours.
I can't recall if she had any issue with anybody because she don't make story with people. She just a jovial person, friendly, cheerful, like to enjoy herself. The face with a lot of women, and it appeared like she was fighting. She was fighting because a lot of mud and so on was in her head and so on. Muddy water. She just, can I see her? She just oozing this kind of muddy water.
Timberlyn Thompson, also called Bibby, one of the residents who made the discovery of the body, said that she was carrying out her daily routine when it was brought to her attention by her cousin that a female body was in a trench nearby. According to Dolly Wayne, the aunt of the now dead woman, it was not unusual for the young woman to be out late. But what was unusual to them was the fact that calls to her phone went unanswered.
Styles, simply different.
Caribbean rice, from the lush rice fields of Guyana, straight to your home. Caribbean rice, our people, our rice.
To get a couch for my mom and a television for my dad, because I like the one that is at courts.
My father wants a bed and my mother wants a TV because it's Santa's Day.
Is this a rap, Santa?
And before we go, Crime Chief Wendell Blanham is back. But not as crime chief. Crime chief Wendell Blanham is back at work, but not as crime chief. This newscast understands that he's now holding the fort as second in command of A Division at Brick Dam. Blanham proceeded on leave shortly after the commission of inquiry was completed into the alleged assassination plot to kill President David Granger. That allegation was made by Diamond resident Andrew Gillard, who told the commission of inquiry that he was offered $7 million by businessman Nazim Khan to kill the president. Some of the recommendations in that report include the removal of Commissioner of Police Silal Pasod and sanctions against Assistant Commissioner of Police David Ramnarine and Crime Chief Wendell Blanham. Recently, Minister of Public Security Kemraj Ramjathan said Blanham is a serious pillar in the Guyana Police Force. The minister was at the time speaking at an Alliance for Change press conference. He said that Blanham had applied for some of his 148 days accumulated leave, which was granted by him. And that's a wrap for this edition of News in Depth. Do join us again same time tomorrow for another edition.